Hi everyone. Welcome to this fireside chat on the migration of SCB's core banking system to AWS. I'm Xavier Loop, Principal Solutions Architect at AWS. I've already 4 years of experience with AWS, and during the last 2 years, I worked directly with SCB teams to support the bank's journey to the cloud. Today, I welcome Anshu Sharma. Anshu, thanks for accepting to join me. For the audience, can you please introduce yourself and describe your role?
Thank you, Xavier, and thank you, everyone. Absolutely delighted to be here. I'm Anshu Sharma Raja. I'm the CIO for Consumer, Private, and Business Banking at Standard Chartered Bank. Standard Chartered, as you know, is a bank with 160 years in the business. We operate in 59 different countries, and we have about 85,000 employees worldwide. Needless to say, there is a huge amount of application footprint we have all, you know, in the last few years and what you see now, and very, very delighted to be working with Amazon Web Services on our journey to cloud.
SCB has been running workloads on AWS since 2015. Can you give us more insight about the current cloud strategy of the bank?
Sure. Since 2015, the cloud strategy has been evolving, and essentially the strategy has evolved based on value that we get out of cloud, right? It's not about just putting every single workload onto cloud, but we are very careful and deliberate about the value-based migration. Essentially saying that by 2025, ideally we would like 75% of our workloads to be operating in cloud.
So today I'm excited to speak with you about the migration of Atlas, your core banking system. So many AWS customers start on the cloud with low-risk migrations. However, SCB decided in 2019 to migrate the core banking system as one of the first workload. So why did you decide to move the most critical application first?
Sure. Can I say that we just picked out and it was Atlas? No, it was clearly not that, right? It was, you know, our strategy was, and Atlas, as you know, is our core banking system, which is really the heart of any banking, any bank for that matter, right? It is the core banking system. And our philosophy was that if you can migrate the core banking with 250 different upstream and downstream interfaces into the cloud, then you can do everything. So this was very well thought out as a showcase for the cloud migration. And essentially, if we move this application, it actually sends out a message both internally and also externally. We actually would be able to then really overcome the challenges that any cloud migration would take. And if we solve for the biggest problems in this migration, then we have really paved the way. That was our philosophy. And lastly, it was important for any successful program of this size and scale to have high visibility. And if we picked the core banking, you know, that was a little bit of a smart move. If we picked core banking, you know, everybody who really mattered was invested in it, and there was clear sponsorship behind this as well.
Clear executive support.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah.
So I know that performance improvement was one of the key drivers for the move to the cloud. So there was a target of reaching 4,000 transactions per second, which was 10 times more than the on-premise system. What were the other key drivers for the move to the cloud of Atlas?
Sure. Performance, clearly, yes, and like you indicated. But, you know, so Atlas, again, is our core banking system, which is, we operate in 42 different markets. There were many, many different flavors of Atlas, you know, depending on, you know, there was a lot of legacy and history. So clearly harmonization, consolidation of technology, and really moving to a modern stack was another big driver. As you would imagine, you know, this infrastructure was getting obsolete, it needed a refresh. There was also the cyber posture, the resiliency posture on top of it. So there were just so many different drivers, and also our ability to deploy changes. The speed to market was another big driver. Should we have done this on-prem? Yes, absolutely. But, you know, if move to cloud really kind of gave us many-fold benefits, and you know, that those were some of the big drivers for us to move to cloud.
When you speak about speed to market, so what were the key elements that you were looking for?
Our ability to deploy changes and not really having to wait for the weekend, that was a big one. Use DevOps, really integrate that. Yes, you can argue that, you know, even on an on-prem environment, you can integrate DevOps, but our ability to really exploit the different availability zones that Amazon Web Services would provide or AWS provides was, you know, one of the things that we were going after, and you know, it really paid off.
Let's take some time with the audience to do some cloud myth busting.
That's going to be a fun one, yeah.
Some people say that hosting PII data and core banking in the cloud is not permitted by regulators. So what is your experience at SCB?
If you say it's not easy, I would agree with you. But if you say it's not permitted, it's clearly a myth. Yes, it's not been easy. We are a heavily regulated organization. Our industry is heavily regulated. And like I said, there are many, many regulators that we deal with because we are dealing with every single country regulator and then also our global regulators. So it was not easy, but there was a lot of work that was required to get approvals and really kind of demonstrate that this is possible. And that was another big payoff that we had at part of this initiative of doing Atlas as the first workload there as well. But there were advantages that AWS provided. For example, the multi-region deployment made it easier to be compliant with country-specific data regulations, especially in markets which required localization like India and Indonesia. Atlas today is deployed in 6 different AWS regions so that, you know, we comply with local regulations. All of this really kind of eased out, which, you know, with our regulators, some of this we would not been able to do it ourselves, right? Because, you know, otherwise you'll have to spin off data centers in all of these different regions and locations. It becomes a very, very costly affair. Then the other thing was standardizing some of these services, really making them compliant and actually, you know, using them for, so you fix them once, and then you are able to reuse them for different countries. That really helped. So in that sense, it's not that it's not permitted. It is tough, but once you cross the first or two steps, then it becomes a very smooth ride.
That's great.
Yeah.
Another myth-busting question.
Okay, bring it on.
Some people say that security is superior on-premises. We know security is an utter priority for a workload like a core banking system. So do you consider it is harder to be secure in the cloud?
I don't think so, right? It's equally hard to secure and continuously keep securing software on-prem. We know it's not a one-time job, likewise in the cloud as well. But the advantage that cloud becomes is, you know, brings forward is all the advanced security capabilities and the amount of automation that are available, you know, today with AWS. Absolutely, we use that and we leverage that to the hilt. The other thing is that we need to invest in a secure landing zone and to also skill our resources to design security and to develop, to design code which is secure from the very beginning, and you're not kind of, you know, really patching it at the end. So essentially, secure by design is a fundamental that we applied. The last bit is that we used, I think, 18 plus different security services that AWS provides and some third-party security solutions, got them validated, got them certified, and, you know, we are using them. So this is, it's as much difficult on either spots, you know, whether it's on-prem or AWS. But in AWS, you kind of standardize a lot more than, you know, having to do the bespoke on on-prem.
Very true. So last myth-busting question. Some people think that the main value of cloud business cases is IT cost reduction. So what is your experience?
Yeah. My view is that definitely there are cost reduction, and that cannot and that should not be your going in premise. Right? There are so many other value adds that moving to cloud brings. For example, scalability. For example, faster time to market. Much stronger innovation. Global deployments, you know, really using all these reliability, you know, zones that that are provided. The blue-green deployment strategy, you know, for example, for us, we were typically deploying on weekends, but now we are able to really kind of deploy on in business hours, etc. Our security and resiliency posture, the amount of cost that was being incurred in really kind of keeping that hygiene level top-notch was significant. Now, if you do all of these and all the benefits, it actually does result in a significant cost reduction. So going in position, if you look at, I only want to have a cost reduction, you know, to me, it is a byproduct of what you do. The cost reduction automatically comes a byproduct. Last not the least, the elastic capacity, right? You're able to kind of turn on and off your workloads on demand and really turn them off over the weekends or on, you know, low utilization days, etc. So that flexibility comes as well. And all of that results in cost reduction. So, you know, my view is that cost reduction happens as a byproduct and not necessarily the first driver.
Very interesting. So SCB core banking application is now running on AWS for over 1 year in some markets. And you have already migrated 10 countries. So where is the Atlas program going from here?
Yeah, it's making a lot of strides. Yes, we migrated 10 countries. In fact, this year alone, and we are in March, we've already done 2 markets already this year. By end of 2023, we aim to do all 42 and, you know, be done with this program and then start, perhaps start teaching others.
What about mainframe migration? I heard that some core banking systems are still running on mainframe. Are you also planning to migrate them to Atlas on the cloud?
Yes, indeed. So that's our next step. You know, that's where we have already started some work. And, you know, eventually we would want to migrate our mainframe workloads onto AWS as well.
So we know that migrating such a critical workload is an ambitious goal. What have been the most interesting, the most important challenges and the lessons learned from the project?
Interesting question. You know, when we look back, when you look back 2-3 years, first of all, the art of possible. Was it even possible? Everybody had doubts. A few had, you know, lesser doubts than the others, but we all kind of, you know, went ahead with that. It took a lot of training and really skilled development. That was the first thing, to really get our team move from a mindset of, you know, on-prem to moving on to cloud. So I think investment in training and our skills development has been tremendous. And then, of course, you know, just the mindset of we try and standardize as much as possible so that you're not kind of reinventing the wheel every single time that you come and attack. You know, constantly looking at benefits in terms of cost optimization, in terms of are we doing it, you know, the right way, et cetera. So keeping a check, some of those things have been tremendous learning. What it has done is it has really paved the way for other applications. So other applications have really leveraged what Atlas has paved out in terms of making standard services available and ready to use. AWS definitely provides a suite, but you know how the bank's procedures are, and you know we have to kind of really make it double, triple, and checked from our compliance standards as well. So now that the suite is ready to be used by others as well. So those investing in some of these upfront has been a tremendous learning as well.
Interesting. So what advice would you give to your peers embarking in a similar strategic migration?
Good question. I think the first thing I would say is, and especially when I'm talking about, you know, these really large, really core workloads, you know, not so much about, you know, the smaller applications, which I think are just most of the time, you know, turn out to be a lift and shift. You're not really re-architecting that. But here, you know, you had to refactor, you had to re-architect, you had to make it cloud ready. I think the first thing I would say is that, you know, be very clear about why do you want to do this? What is the purpose of moving on to cloud? So, you know, think and be clear in your mind around that. You know, of course, we'll start small like we did. You know, there is no big bang here. But have the blueprint to scale ready with yourselves, right? I think that is important. The third thing we would say is that we sometimes fall into this trap of, you know, I already have these services available or I can build it internally. Why don't I go down that path? We have a large army of software engineers, et cetera, et cetera. So why don't we build that? But I think, you know, it's important to use what is readily available, certify that, make it fit for purpose, and standardize as much as possible, because that's what gives you the economies of scale. So really leverage the cloud native services and investing in certifying those rather than building bespoke would be my advice.
That's great. So I have a last question. So the core mission of SCB is here for good. So I went to the SCB portal website, and I noticed what one of the main targets of the bank is to improve sustainability and reduce carbon footprint. How can AWS Cloud help SCB achieve its sustainability goals?
Yeah, so we are absolutely a very passionate organization about Here for Good. And if you've seen, you know, some of our new, you know, advertisements are, you know, specifically talking about some of the things. So it's really important. It's very core to what we do in terms of, you know, the carbon footprint. So a couple of things, I think, you know, the fantastic thing is that AWS also believes in the same strategy. Your data centers are green. But more importantly, what we've seen recently is access to the AWS carbon footprint report, you know, which actually gives you where you are, right? It gives you a sense of what is your carbon footprint like. And I personally believe that unless you are able to measure something, you there's no way you can track it. So, you know, that is important, and it helps us optimize our resource consumption. The other thing is that AWS is also constantly working with us in optimizing and further, you know, using engineering to optimize what our green footprint is. The good example right now, as you know, that we are testing out the migration to the ARM processes, the newer line of it, which gives us 40% more efficiency on the database side. So I think those measures, you know, the fact that it's also a constant thing to think on AWS side as well as it is for us, you know, really makes it worthwhile.
Thanks a lot, Anshu, for taking the time to answer my questions. For the audience, I would like to mention that you can get more technical details about the Atlas migration to AWS by watching the Atlas testimonial from the reInvent 2021 conference. Thanks a lot for attending this session. We hope you found it valuable.
Thank you, Xavier.